for another half an hour. And that's, by the way, that's more recommended in the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وبارك يا ربنا على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. Dear respected brothers and sisters, after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His great bounties on each one of us, the bounties that we should be proud of, the bounty of Islam, the bounty of Iman, the bounty of Quran. And after asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our love to the great Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may the blessing and the peace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon him, upon his family, upon his wives, upon his companions, and upon his followers who are going to follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with benevolence, with fearing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till the day of judgment. InshaAllah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we discussed yesterday, we're still in another garden, from one of the gardens of the gardens of the paradise, as Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam has given it as a glad tiding to the ummah of Muhammad. And we're still inshaAllah in a gathering that's being surrounded by the angels, having the tranquility sent upon them, overshadowed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. And on the top of all of that, our names are mentioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His dominion, as Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam did say, وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling His great creation, see how great are the human being, those who did come in one place, devoting their time, being dedicated, serving their deen, making it to the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Jannah, and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect them from the hellfire. And as mentioned in the hadith, we have been asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the great Jannah. And Allah is telling His angels, have they seen the Jannah? And the angels are saying, Ya Allah, they have not seen it yet. And Allah is telling them, what about if they have seen it? And we have been asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all of us from the hellfire, which is horrible. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling His angels, because the angels are saying, Ya Allah, we are the one who has been taking care of the shift of Fajr and the shift of Asr. We are the one who is writing, reporting all of their deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking His angels, and the narration said, and He's more aware of what we are doing. وَهُوَ أَعْلَمْ. How you have left them behind. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the best, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanna report it, wanna teach it to the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the angels are saying, Ya Allah, they are making tasbih, they are making tahmid, they are making takbir, they are praising you, Ya Allah. And they have been asking you for Jannah. And they have been asking you to protect them from the hellfire. Have they seen the hellfire? And the angels are saying, no, Ya Allah, they have not yet. And Allah would say, what should be the situation if they have seen it? Because the hellfire is horrible. It's just what we know about, it's just the name, what has been described. But the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared it as torment and punishment for those who did violate the link between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the same way we discussed yesterday about Jannah, whatever your eye has never seen, whatever your ears have never heard of, whatever your heart has never thought of. مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذْنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى قَلْبِ بَشْرٍ. The same way exactly for the other side. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. The same way, to the extent that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, if Allah will bring somebody from the hellfire, and he will be thrown in the most horrible fire of the fires of dunya, he will take his nap. That's the time of his nap. It's a completely different story. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to bring the one who has never seen grievance in his dunya at all. All of his time, all of his dunya is fun, enjoyment, violating rule, drinking, whatever you want to do. He has never had a concern about his deen. Why I should stop, why I should not stop. And I'm going to do whatever will come to my mind. It is what it is. He has never seen a hardship in his life at all. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام would say, فيغمس في النار غمسة. He has not made it to the hellfire. The Prophet said, he has been dipped. Just a dip. He has not made it to the hellfire. Eternal. خالداً فيها. No. The Prophet said, يغمس في النار غمسة. Just a dip. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask him, عبدي هل رأيت نعيما قط? Have you ever seen enjoyment in your life? And that servant is saying, والله أنا في الشقاء منذ خلقتني. والله يا الله, I swear by Allah that I am in a horrible situation since I have been created. A dip has made him forgetting all of his enjoyment life, a dip. The palaces, the servants, the power, the transgression, whatever he has been doing, all are gone. A dip. We have not talked about any other levels in the hellfire. Just a dip. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring somebody who has been going through a lot of tests in dunya. Too much hardship. And just, it's full of tests. He has never seen the enjoyment in dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, but he did pass the exams. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَيُغْمَسُ فِي الْجَنَّةِ غَمْسَ. He will be dipped just once in Jannah. And Allah will get him out. And Allah will ask him, O my servant, have you ever seen hard time in your life? And he's saying, me, ya Allah? Wallahi, I have been enjoyment since I have been created. Just a dip. We are not talking about Jannah, عَرْضُهَا السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. We are not talking about a paradise. The width of is like earth and heavens. We are not talking about one gate or one door on one frame of one of the doors, in one of the buildings, in one of the gardens, in one of the farms, in one of the plots for anyone in Jannah. And that frame, as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did say, as an example for Abu Bakr, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, whomever will accept, whomever will hate. The second man in this ummah, the great companion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we cannot believe how some categories who might claim themselves belonging to Muslims, and they are accusing that the reputation and the credibility of Abu Bakr, and they hate Abu Bakr, or curse Abu Bakr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning him, the second man in the cave, the second man in Islam, after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That will take us to our whole discussion today. Because the game is too serious. And some of the game aspects is coming from those who are claiming themselves belonging to Islam. Once you have accused the credibility of the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we need to understand. If Muhammad is saying, Allah has given me the revelation to get married to Aisha, and somebody is accusing the reputation of Aisha, that means you are accusing the revelation. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a, زَوَّجَنِ اللَّهُ بِعَائِشَ مِنْ فَوْقِ سَبْعِ سَمَوَاتِ, I received the revelation from the top of the seventh heaven to get married to Aisha. And somebody is accusing the credibility and the reputation of one of the mothers of the believers whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did indicate them in the Quran. The next step will be the accusing the credibility of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accusing the credibility of the prophets, accusing the credibility of the whole message. If we cannot talk politely about Yusuf alayhi salam and the other prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we miss the whole point. If we are accusing Jibreel alayhi salam, the angel of Allah, that he did something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not set in the plan, which God we are talking about? Which God that his messenger is gonna go and do his own? That's Islam. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. But the only thing that's making the hearts getting cooled a little bit, that's what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did mention 1430 years ago. We know already what's the situation. We know who they are. We know what's their plan and what's their agenda. And by the end, it will be what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. It will be the same way. And it's enough for us to worry from the hellfire to know that the least people being punished in the day of judgment, the least, one person out of millions or billions who are going to make it to the hellfire, wal-iyadhu billah, the least amongst them is Abu Talib, the uncle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he has only one level for him. That's the top, the least level of punishment in the day of judgment. You know what Muhammad did describe that very low level of punishment? He said, Abu Talib, he did not make it. He did not say the statement of Shahada and Tawheed before he passed away, with all what he did to support and protect Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It was for the relationship. It was for the relationship, not to the sake of Allah. And he did make it, and it was never a situation for the heart of Muhammad to feel that sadness the way that he felt when Abu Talib did pass away without saying La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. He did his best to the last breath in his life. Amma, just say it. Ashfa' laka biha 'inda Rabbi yawm al-qiyam. Just mention it. And I'm going to intercede using that statement before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment. And he kept making it. He kept repeating the same request from Abu Talib. But the evil is almost everywhere. And that's their way. The shaitans of ins and jinn, Abu Lahab and the rest of the group, has been surrounding the bed of Abu Talib. Abu Talib, are you going to leave the religion of your grandparents? And they kept making it back and forth till he passed away without saying La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. And Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam felt so sad. And he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, with what happened, can I ask you to forgive him? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, no. And it has become the only Makki verse in the chapter of Tawbah. If I remember 123, 124, ما كان للنبي والذين آمنوا معه أن يستغفروا للمشركين ولو كانوا أولي قربى. It's not allowed for the Prophet and the believers to ask Allah to forgive any one of the mushrikeen, even if he has a relationship with them. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, because of what he has done, although it was not to the sake of Allah, he is at the least level of punishment in the Day of Judgment. What's that level, Ya Allah? Abu Talib is stepping on two small pieces of stones of fire, like the size of pea. One beneath each one of the 2 feet. And the Prophet said, يَغْلِي مِنْهُمَ دَمُ رَأْسِهِ أَبَدَ الْآبِدِينَ. And that piece of stone of fire is making the blood in Abu Talib's brain boiling eternal. And that's the least level of punishment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. It's worthy to run away from, as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to teach the ummah of Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam. InshaAllah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we discussed yesterday, there are two main concepts that's hitting some of the bases in the faith of the believers. And one of them is related to prophets, to the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if somebody will say that, just like even with Isa alayhi salam, with Moses alayhi salam, that the reason as Muslims losing the faith in any one of them, if we are not gonna admit that he is one of Allah's prophets, with all what you are doing as Muslim, you are out of Islam. It's a major part of the pillars of Iman. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد منهم. We are not even allowed to say, X is better than Y, or I love X and I hate Y. Prophets, they are coming from the same source. The one who sent is the same, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The credibility is the same. And that is the reason, if you are talking about the authentic, there is no way it could be a conflict. There is no way. And if we are accusing that why Allah has sent it to Muhammad the same way that Abu Jahl did ask, why did Allah find, didn't Allah find any other than you to receive the message? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away did reply, who are you? Who are those human beings who are gonna judge Allah's choice? Allahu a'lamu haythu yaj'alu risalata. Allah knows the best who's gonna receive the message. Who's gonna take care of it? Who's gonna deliver it? You are accusing who? You are accusing the Creator and you are saying that you are worshipping Him. You are accusing somebody He might not be qualified enough to take the decision of who is gonna take care of the message. And you are saying that's the one you are worshipping. Which God you are worshipping? How you can call Him Subhan? How you can call Him Subhanallah? How you can say that He is perfect? How you can say that He is the one who will never die and will never sleep? Huh? If somebody can freak Him here and there. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. As we agreed yesterday, inshallah, we'll take two cadres, two scenes from the chapter of Yusuf alayhi salam. I believe we started a part of 6 months ago. What will continue, inshallah, we'll take two themes, and each one of them is going to carry a message. We stopped by Yusuf alayhi salam, how the whole situation has ended up with Yusuf in the well, with the plan of his brothers. They tried to make it, they made it with their father Yaqub alayhi salam. He gave Yusuf to them and he doesn't know what's the plan. And he did make it. They left him in the well. Now we can get back to Yaqub saying whatever we want to say. But now we will be able to capture the full love of Yaqub's heart. And we are going to repent to Allah of what we did. We are going to try to be righteous. And he came back to Yaqub. They started, just give us Yusuf and we'll take care of him. He's the youngest. We'll try to let him play. We're going to try to let him enjoy. And they came back with a completely different story. We have gone to race, and we have gone to play, and we have left Yusuf next to our stuff. And unfortunately, the wolf did eat him over. And to complete the whole plan, they brought his shirt, as that's called the chapter of shirts. We have in that chapter three shirts. Can we mention what are the three shirts? Huh? That's the chapter that has the three shirts. Huh? One, the brothers has brought to Yaqub alayhi salam, just like mixed with the blood of one of the goats, and no single cut in the whole shirt. Coming back with the shirt, telling Yaqub, إِنَّا ذَهَبْنَا نَسْتَبِقْ وَتَرَكْنَا يُوسُفَ عِنْدَ مَتَاعِنَا. Oops! فَأَكَلَهُ الذِّئْبُ وَمَا أَنْتَ بِمُؤْمِنٍ لَنَا وَلَوْ كُنَّا صَادِقِينَ. And the wolf did eat Yusuf. And here is the only thing we can get out of that whole Yusuf is the shirt mixed with blood. And Yusuf, Yaqub alayhi salam, did hold the shirt, and he has found the shirt is mixed with blood, but there is no single cut. And he told them, how merciful is that wolf? Just like, it's like a magic to eat Yusuf from inside, and the shirt is nothing. That is the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did confirm it in the Quran. وَجَاءُ عَلَىٰ قَمِيصِهِ بِدَمٍ كَذِبٍ. It's false blood. And Yaqub alayhi salam has realized that there is something is wrong. And he made it right away. قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ أَمْرًا. You have made a plan. وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَىٰ مَا تَصِفُونَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is my support on what you have plotted. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, because there is another plan which will proceed whomever will accept, whomever will deny, which is Allah's plans, and that will never change. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the plan for some of the merchants are coming from Egypt, passing by, going to the well. He sent somebody to bring the water out of the well. He just get the jar inside, and the jar got stuck in a man that Allah has given him. As Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam did say, half of the beauty on the whole earth. Utiya Yusuf shatr al-jamal. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam has been given half of the beauty on the whole earth. And the narration said, wa utiya Muhammad al-jamal kulla. And Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam has been given the whole beauty. Alayhi salatu wasalam. They send the guy, the jar had come with the kid, with the youth. قالوا يا بشرى هذا غلام وأسروه بضاعة. And they have taken him as a good, fine, we got something that we can sell. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made Yusuf alayhi salam going with them, with the whole caravan to Egypt. And once they are there, they said, just like, what we are going to do? They could not even value what they have in their hand. A son. We discussed yesterday. We said the Honorable Prophet, the son of the Honorable Prophet, the son of the Honorable Prophet, the son of the Honorable Prophet. They have in their hand Yusuf, the son of Yaqub, the son of Ishaq, the son of Ibrahim, alayhim wa ala nabina afdala salatin wa salam. How great is such family? But they could not appreciate what they have in hand. They don't know. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did say, وَشَرَوْهُ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ. They sold him very cheap in Egypt. Whomever has come to offer, oh, just like just a small kid, and we are gonna buy it. Just buy, sell, and they made it for a few bucks. دراهم معدودة وكانوا فيه من الزاهدين. Just we don't know. It might end up with a problem. Let's get rid of him for anything. Whomever will be offered, and it has ended up with this, and he has been sold to get into the house of Al-Aziz, the governor or the ruler of Egypt at that time, or the minister of finance of Egypt at that time. Right away, that's what we are going to start with. We have been talking about credibility of prophets, politeness while talking about prophets, Same we are talking about the companions whom Allah have chosen them to be the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even those have been chosen. They were not prophets, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did pick them up to be the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did grant and confirm their truthfulness in the Quran. رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا عَهَدُوا اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَدَ نَحْبَهِ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا. This were the men whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made them truthful in their covenant with Allah, the companions of Muhammad, the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How we have to be polite. And we agreed yesterday, if there is something, it might not look reasonable, accuse your way of thinking. It has nothing wrong to do with the Quran. If you cannot understand it, if you will find the understanding is taking you odd, either left or right. It has nothing to do with the Quran. It's something to do with your understanding. It's something to do with your limited amount of knowledge and information. It has nothing to do with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How Allah? Just like the two verses are, I can feel them conflicting. You are saying that Allah has conflict in the book of Allah because, you know, there are too many, Allah has repeated the same, and I would say if it's removed what? Are you playing with, you are talking about the book of Allah, the Holy Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed. You are not talking about a poem that you want to change here and there, Eden, and it doesn't work. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it. Now we have not talked about the situation of Al-Aziz yet, about the woman yet, about what we can think of the interpretation of those verses yet. Before even he's still, we said he's the support of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the first day when he brought the vision to Yusuf alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has shown him how he has seen 11 planets prostrating to him in addition to the sun and moon, a total of 13. Parents and 11 brothers. That's Allah's support at stage one. Second, with all the plans the kids, the brothers have been going through. Once they left him in the well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salam to Yusuf, telling him, وَلَتُنَبِّئَنَّهُمْ بِأَمْرِهِمْ هَذَا وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. Yusuf, you are under my plan, not their plan. And one day you are going to inform them of what they have done. When? That's Allah's plan. And no one knows when. Yusuf never thought it will be after 40 or 50 years. But Allah told him, they have made their plan to get rid of you. And I have my plan to make it a completely different scenario. Third, here is the location of that verse. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did say, Yusuf have been sold. Everyone is feeling that a prophet while being kid is being sold as a slave, and we are feeling bad. Is it correct? Just like right away, the location of the verse after the verse dealing with selling Yusuf alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَكَذَلِكَ مَكَّنَّا لِيُوسُفْ. In that location, Allah is saying, that way we have given the power to Yusuf. Power? You have not gone through the other verses yet. Allah is saying, وَشَرَوْهُ بِثَمَنٍ بَخْسٍ دَرَاهِمَ مَعْدُودَ وَكَانُوا فِيهِ مِنَ الزَّاهِدِينَ. They sold him for a few bucks. Right away. وَكَذَلِكَ مَكَّنَّا لِيُوسُفَ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلِنُعَلِّمَهُ مِنْ تَأْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. 9, 10 years old, and Allah is telling us, forget about what you are thinking, that Yusuf is lost, Yusuf is in a bad situation, that's not yours. Allah is saying, that is the way I have given the power to Yusuf. That is the way Yusuf will become powerful. How? That's not your job. And Allah is saying, وَلِنُعَلِّمَهُ مِنْ تَأْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. A part of the support that we are going to give Yusuf alayhi salam, he will be given one of Allah's signs to Yusuf alayhi salam, the interpretation of visions. وَلِنُعَلِّمَهُ مِنْ تَأْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. And Allah is telling everyone who want to think in a different way, be careful. وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَىٰ أَمْرِ. Allah will enforce His plan. And as we mentioned yesterday, وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But the majority of the people don't know. They cannot understand it. Don't say how Allah is going to find me an exit if I fear Him. It's not your job. That's not your part. Do the first, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of the rest. Do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded. How? It's not yours. How the fire has become burden wa salaman ala Ibrahim. How the fire has been cool and safe for Ibrahim alayhi salam. How the whole sea has been converted to land for Musa alayhi salam. How Muhammad alayhi salam has been protected. How Muhammad has been taken to the journey of Isra and Mi'raj. How the water has come out of the hand of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. How the food has been blessed in the hand of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. How the tree did come making a groove in the whole land, prostrating in front of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, saying, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and bear witness that you, Muhammad, is the Prophet of Allah. How the lion has taken Sufayna, the servant of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when one of his servants got lost in the desert, and he faced a lion, and the God just, you're dealing with what? Lion. And Sufayna, the only way he can make it, he told him, lion, be careful, I am Sufayna, the servant of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the narration said that the lion has given a ride to Sufayna to the border of Medina. And by the border of Medina, he did shake his tail, saying, deliver my salam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How? That's not ours. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will get into the subject that everyone is getting his misunderstanding, and we are getting in a situation that we might be in a big trouble regarding faith. Again, accusing a prophet, accusing the message. Accusing the message, accusing the messenger, accusing the messenger, accusing the one who is revealing. Simple. And you are God. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has started to give us the idea that Yusuf alayhi salam did grow up. He has been sold to that man and his wife. They have not been blessed with kids for any reason, regardless what the books of tafsir did say. But they have no kids. And they have agreed with one another, they will take Yusuf alayhi salam as, and we need to understand that, as their son. And there is nothing in Islam called as their son. It doesn't work. Whomever is strange is going to continue forever to be strange. That is the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at certain level, at certain stage of the revelation of the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He has made the adoption completely forbidden. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even with the story of Zayd, one of the greatest companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who used to be called at that time Zayd the son of Muhammad, because of the absolute love from Zayd to the Prophet, to the extent that he did recommend to stay with Muhammad after even his father was able to locate him in Mecca. He kept looking for him for years. He has been kidnapped years and years back in one of the wars. And he kept looking for his son. And he did locate him in Mecca. He came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked him, can I get my son back? And he told him, I have no problem. Whatever Zayd will decide, he will go for it. And they asked Zayd, you have not seen your father for years and years. And now you have the chance. You have nothing binding you to stay with Muhammad in Mecca. What do you recommend? Your father want to take you back to the hug of your family. or staying with Muhammad? He said, I'll never leave Muhammad till the last minute in my life. And since then, he has been called at that time Zayd, the son of Muhammad, till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed the whole story in the chapter of Al-Ahzab regarding Zayd, and he's the only companion of the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did mention his name in the Quran. فَلَمَّا قَضَى زَيْدٌ مِّنْهَا وَطَرًا. And it was the story of Zayd radiallahu anhu and Zaynab bint Jahsh, the cousin of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They got married to one another, she has been divorced, and during their time, and which is the case, it was not allowed for the man to get married to the ex-wife of his son. But Zayd in reality is not the son of Muhammad. He has been considered as, and there is nothing in Islam called as. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did reveal the final forbidding the adoption, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did make it clear, ادعوهم لآبائهم, call them for their fathers. And since that day, he has come back to be Zayd ibn Haritha, the father of Usama ibn Zayd ibn Haritha, حب رسول الله وابن حب رسول الله, the most beloved to the heart of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the son of the most beloved to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the man and the woman has taken Yusuf alayhi salam as their son. But Yusuf is growing up, and we agreed how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the beauty to Yusuf. But a man is a man and a woman is a woman. Nothing called as for those who are taking it. It's just like they are like brothers, and it's ending up with a disaster. And after, instead of crying water, we are crying blood, because we have violated the whole rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has started. Now he has grown up. And the situation is, Yusuf has become an adult, a man, with that great beauty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him. Regardless, there is nothing called as. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is dealing with the hearts differently. There is no way a mother can have an attraction towards her son. It doesn't work. And if there is a case as such, something has been flipped upside down. Drugs, and we have been hearing about tens of flipping the whole nature of Allah's creation. And that can only happen when the whole nature of Allah's creation may be messed up. Other than that, it doesn't work. But because he is not her son, she has started to get an attraction towards Yusuf alayhi salam, to the extent وراودته التي هو في بيتها عن نفسه وغلقت الأبواب وقالت هيت لك. We are getting closer to the misconception that we are getting involved in that might affect the faith of Muslims. Allah is saying she has seduced him. She has tried to do anything to let Yusuf alayhi salatu was salam committing wal-iyadu billah, the nasty, the filthy action with her. To the extent she has closed the door, she want to make sure that no one can get in, and she want to make the absolute soulness between Yusuf alayhi salam and her. Those who have been talking about Yusuf, right away did say, ma'ad Allah. He did say, right away, ma'ad Allah. I'm asking the refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the fourth support from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Yusuf alayhi salam, in the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from those who are not prophets, who are not even companions. The seven categories whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will shadow them, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have them under the shade of Allah on a day there is no shade but the shade of Allah. One of the seven categories, ورجل دعته امرأة ذات منصب وجمال فقال لها إني أخاف الله. Just one of the true believers from the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will be seduced by one of the women, and that woman has power and beauty, because the come bringing the two subjects, these two factors together, is very tough. You might resist the beauty, but it might be another threatening, that if you will not follow, you will go to hell. You will be behind here and there. And the Prophet saying she has power and beauty. And the Prophet said, the Ummah of Muhammad, those who are coming to the masjid, those who have real faith in their hearts, will be able to say, Ma'ad Allah, inni akhafu Allah. I cannot do that. I am fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What about the Prophet that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when I have every single second of his life under his eye? And that is the way with every Prophet. Every Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way that's, the word that's mentioned in the Quran in Arabic, it can be translated manufactured. It's being done, being made. وَلِتُصْنَعَ عَلَى عَيْنِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making him under his eye, a second by second, a minute by minute, with Allah's protection as such, is gonna fall down in that horrible trap. قَالَ مَعَاذَ اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ رَبِّ أَحْسَنَ مَثْوَايِ إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken care of me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me the glad tidings of what's gonna happen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored me. And you want me to get into that trap? إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ Those oppressors who are gonna oppress themselves by the violating the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never be successful. That's what Yusuf is saying from step zero. How we can come later on because of two words that we misunderstand, saying Yusuf was almost on the way to, it was almost on the way to commit with whom? And you're gonna see some of the corrupted books that what happened between Yusuf and ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله وراودته التي هو في نفسها في بيتها عن نفسها وغلقت الأبواب وقالت هيت لك قال معاذ الله إنه ربي أحسن مثواي إنه لا يفلح الظالمون ولقد همت به وهم بها and that's the location of the whole misunderstanding what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying he has initiated to do what and she has initiated to do what that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying and the ham the initiation of Yusuf how it could be the same the initiation of the woman and let's see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned from the same verse from the same Quran we have taken a step by step and a stage by stage how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is protecting Yusuf alayhi salam. وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا لَوْلَا أَنْ رَأَى بُرْهَانَ رَبِّهِ كَذَلِكَ لِنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ السُّوءَ وَالْفَحْشَاءَ إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ Quran says, he has initiated two, huh? But for believers, we will see how we can take from the verse what that verb should be. وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ Her initiation we understand because we have seen what she has planned from day one. But what Yusuf alayhi salam has is initiated to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, the burhan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought in the heart of Yusuf is the same faith, is the same iman. It's the same fearing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has brought the reminders in front of his eye and that can stop any believer from committing the haram or violating the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the scholars have agreed upon. Allah didn't say, كَذَلِكَ لِنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ الْفَحْشَاءِ If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fahsha is the filthy action. Allah didn't say only that we have avoided Yusuf alayhi salam from committing the adultery. Allah did say, we have stopped Yusuf from committing su first, something bad, hitting the woman, and that was the, he has initiated to hit the woman that he was thinking that she is like his mother. The one he has a value for her because she is the one who has taken care of him. When he was a kid, starting in her house, and he was in the way because of her initiation, to hurt her, to beat her. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought that whole reminder in front of his eye, he stopped. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken two levels of stopping. One, to hurt even that woman. Second, is to get involved in that fahsha or the filthy action, which is the adultery. That's stage number 5 of the protection. Stage number 6, إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. That word in Quran has a meaning. Allah didn't say إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُصْلِحِينَ. إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. He's one of the believers. He's one of the great servants. No. Allah did say, إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. Those who are purified, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken that absolute seed of evil out of their heart. And that particular attribute of believers, Allah has used it, the only attribute that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has used it for the shaitan, for not being able to deceive. لَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمْ الْمُخْلَصِينَ. I can deviate any one of them, except those who are really under that character, those who are really purified. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in that particular situation, is telling everyone, Yusuf is one of our servants who are holding that attribute, that the shaitan cannot play that game with them. He is one of those who have been purified. إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken us through that. If somebody was on the way to get into the filthy action, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, why have to run? The only way he has decided, we have to visualize it. The whole room is closed, all doors are blocked. And he has only one option, to beat her up or to do something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has shown him that reminder that beating this woman, she is like your mother. She is the one who has taken care of you for years and years. And you cannot do the other side. So you have been protected from both. But you have only 4 walls. Doors are blocked. Locked up. You need to do something. What he has started to do?
Huh? You run.
Run away. Find any way. Let me run. وَاسْتَبَقَ الْبَابِ وَقَدَّتْ قَمِيصَهُ مِنْ دُبُرِ. And he started to run towards the door. Let me try even to break that lock, to do something, to unlock it. And she ran behind him. وَقَدَّتْ قَمِيصَهُ مِنْ دُبُرٍ. And she ripped his shirt from the back, which is the second shirt. Now is the second. Where is the third? The last one that will be sent back to Ya'qub alayhi salam to bring his side back, that Yusuf will take off, give it to the caravan, take it to my father, take it to his father, who has become blind out of the grievance that he has in his heart for losing Ya'qub and Binyamin, the two of them. And Yusuf alayhi salam, he told them, just فَأَلْقُوهُ عَلَى وَجْهِ أَبِي يَأْتِ بَصِيرًا وَأْتُونِي بِأَهْلِكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. Just go, throw it on the face of my father, and he will get his eye, he will get his sight back. But that was not the miracle, as we will see inshallah maybe in other sessions. Once the caravan has left Egypt, Ya'qub was where? Palestine. وَلَمَّا فَصَلَتِ الْعِيرِ. Just started to leave Egypt, Ya'qub in Palestine did say, قَالَ أَبُوهُمْ إِنِّي لَأَجِدُ رِيحَ يُوسُفْ لَوْلَ أَن تُفَنِّدُونَ. I'm smelling I'm getting the smell of Yusuf, but I don't want to say that, otherwise you are going to think that I lost my mind. And once they made it, and they made it on the face of Ya'qub alayhi salam, فَارْتَدَّ بَصِيرًا. He brought, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did bring his sight back. She did run behind him, she ripped his shirt from the back. The same time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the plan for guys from outside to come and open the door. He was the man, her wife, and another person with him from one of the family members is holding a baby. And they have seen the scene. Yusuf alayhi salam is facing the door. The man and the man with him, the president or the minister and the man with him holding the baby, they are next to one another, and what they can see that Yusuf alayhi salam is in the front and something is, it's like, it's going on. And she is in the back. And what she's going to say, just, and that's the way of woman. Right away, she forgot everything. قالت ما جزاء من أراد بأهلك سوءا إلا أن يسجن أو عذاب أليم. What do you say about somebody who has tried to do something wrong with your wife, other than being in the jail or being subjected to a painful torment? What? Me? قال هي راودتني عن نفسي. I have nothing. She has tried to seduce me. What I can say? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the narration has come from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was clear for everyone. If I'm gonna look at somebody, his shirt is ripped from the back, what the hell is going on? And you're telling me that she is in the back and his shirt is ripped from the back and Yusuf, his face is facing the two guys, and you're telling me that Yusuf is the one who has been trying to do something with the woman? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Yusuf alayhi salam not to make it out of his tongue, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made that infant on the shoulder of the other man, as Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam did say, three infants Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did make them speaking up in their cradle, fil mahd. Three. First is Isa alayhi salam. Second is Ibn Mashitat Banati Fir'aun, the son of the woman who is to be the camp of the daughters of Pharaoh in the chapter of Al-Buruj. Huh? Third is Shahid Yusuf, which is called the witness of Yusuf alayhi salam. And there is another narration called saying four. Who is the fourth? Juraij al-Abid, one of the worshipper, one of the monks of the children of Israel, who was worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way that one day he did not listen to his mother. He was praying, but he didn't listen to her. He did not reply to her at once. And she said, she made dua against him. And he's one of the scholars of the children of Israel. And she said, Ya Allah, don't let Juraij, wal-iyadu billah, don't let him pass away. Hatta wal-iyadu billah, it's till he will be subjected to a big issue with the prostitutes. And he was praying. He was not doing anything wrong. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made that one of the prostitutes in the community of the children of Israel, she has tried to seduce Juraij many times, and she failed. He's the scholar, he's the worshipper. And one day she said, I'm gonna do something with this man. And she went to one of the shepherds, she made the fahsha, she committed the adultery with him, she got pregnant, and she came, it was no DNA, no nothing. She came back saying, what I have in my womb is the son of Juraij. And they brought Juraij, wallahi, me? Al-Abid, the worshipper, the scholar? And that's the da'wah of the mother and father. We need to be very careful while dealing with our kids. Never ever, under any circumstances of anger, make dua against your kids. Because if it will meet a moment of acceptance, it will happen. The same way that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam did advise, don't make in a moment of anger a dua against your wealth and your kids. Because if it will meet a moment of Allah's acceptance, it will happen the way it is. And they have taken the guy, you are the scholar, you are the worshipper, she has delivered the baby. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's one subject with the woman. But because of his worshipping to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his piety, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made that infant on the shoulder of the prostitute to speak in the cradle saying, Juraij has nothing to do with me, my father is so and so and so. And that the witness of Yusuf alayhi salam did say, that's simple guys. In kana qamisuhu qudda min qubul, and it's clear, it's not if his shirt has been ripped from the front. He is liar and she's truthful. Because that's the way, it's a face to face. وَإِنْ كَانَ قَمِيسُهُ قُدَّ مِنْ دُبُرٍ. And if his shirt has been ripped from the back. She is liar. And he is truthful. فَلَمَّا رَأَى قَمِيسَهُ قُدَّ مِنْ دُبُرٍ قَالَ إِنَّهُ مِنْ كَيْدِكُنْ إِنَّ كَيْدَكُنَّ عَظِيمٌ. The man who has seen his wife and it has been a case. The only thing he can say, oh, I know that you women are not that good. Okay, my wife, just take your time. That's what he did. And that is the reason there is no punishment, there is no serious action. She did not stop. But she made it even at a larger scale. Because the story has become like an issue in the whole city. وَقَالَ نِسْوَةٌ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ امْرَأَةُ الْعَزِيزُ تُرَاوِدُ فَتَاهَا عَنْ نَفْسِهِ قَدْ جَغَفَهَا حُبَّ. Everyone seeing in the city, just the wife of that man is, she want to do something with Yusuf. But he's not accepting. فَلَمَّا سَمِعَتْ بِمَكْرِهِنْ. She has heard everyone talking about him. She want to tell them, you are making fun of me. You are blaming me for falling in that love with this man. Because you have not seen that man. You don't know who he is. And how he looks like. فَلَمَّا سَمِعَتْ بِمَكْرِهِنْ. She has made a banquet. She has invited all women in Medina. And whenever they were there, eating, and everyone every one of the women is holding his knife, taking care of the apple or the fruit she has in her hand. وَقَالَ تُخْرُجْ عَلَيْهِنْ. Yusuf, get out, do something, he will pass by. فَلَمَّا رَأَيْنَهُ. Once they have seen him, فَلَمَّا رَأَيْنَهُ أَكْبَرْنَهُ وَقَطَّعْنَا أَيْدِيَهُنْ. They have cut their hands without even feeling, out of the beauty and dignity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given Yusuf alayhi salam. And once they did, she told them, see what you have done? فَذَلِكُنَّ الَّذِي لُمْتُنَّنِي فِيهِ. That is the one you blamed me for. وَلَقَدْ رَاوَدْتُهُ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ فَاسْتَعْصَمْ. I have seduced him. Now we understand the story. And he did not accept. وَلَئِنْ لَمْ يَفْعَلْ مَا أَمُرُهُ. And if he's not gonna do whatever I'm asking, or commanding him, or instructing him to do. لَيُسْجَنَنْ وَلَيَكُونَ مِّنَ الصَّاغِرِ. He will be in the jail, or I'm gonna put him down. Now it's not an invitation from one. That has become a party. It has become a whole. قَالَ رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي. It has become, that's not only the wife. Everyone wanna try to do the same. And Yusuf alayhi salam, clear. Jail or وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, that sin. قَالَ رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ. Yeah, Allah, jail is more beloved to my heart than what they are inviting me to commit. وَلَئِنْ لَمْ تَصْرِفْ عَنِّي كَيْدَهُنَّ أَصْبُ إِلَيْهِنَّ. If I don't have Allah's support and Allah's protection, stage number 7, under the eye of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَصْبُ إِلَيْهِنَّ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ. I'm gonna fall down, and that will never happen because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection is next to Yusuf alayhi salam. And when she has realized that this man, we have no use, there is no way we can play that game with him, she has made the decision. Now, I need to, just like, the reputation in the whole city has become nasty. And we need to do something. And she has made it in a way, false accusation. And she has brought this woman as false witness. This woman as false witness. He has tried to group her. He has tried to do something with her. And all of them has made the witness against Yusuf alayhi salam. And he has made it to the jail. The second Qadr. Is it a good situation for Yusuf alayhi salam to be in the jail? Same. That what we can judge from our own. That what we said last night. It might be the darkest minute of the night. And we feel it so bad. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a different plan, because Fajr will be coming after the darkest minute of that night. And Yusuf alayhi salam, that's what I kept telling the brother. Be the servant of Allah. Some of the brothers are making themselves serving Allah conditional. If I'm not going to be the president, I'm not going to serve my deen. If I'm not going to be in the board, I'm not going to serve my deen. If I'm not going to be the imam, I'm not going to serve my deen. If I'm not going to be have the power in hand, I'm not going to serve my deen. If I'm not going to get the power of attorney to sign the checks, I'm not going to serve my deen. Which deen you are trying to serve? I want to serve my deen in even cleaning the bathroom. If you need to serve your deen, whatever a chance you will be given, otherwise you are lying and you have your own personal agenda and interest. You serve Allah, you want to serve Allah. There is nothing called with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's conditional. Either my way or go away. It doesn't work with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever you can. Just painting the wall. Helping some of the kids, teaching Quran. Whatever you can. Guarding the masjid. Whatever you can. But you want to make it, oh Muhammad, either I'm going to be... That's what the kuffar did with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Kick those poor guys out of your gathering and will be with you and will believe. What you are talking about? And the Prophet, for sure, he has never accepted. Not only that, the Prophet has been blamed for listening to such invitation. وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيُّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهًا. Retain yourself with those who are remembering Allah day and night. And in another whole chapter of blaming, عبس وتولى أن جاءه الأعمى وما يدريك لعله يذكر أو يذكر فتنفعه الذكر. أما من استغنى فأنت له تصدى وما عليك ألا يزكى. وأما من جاءك يسعى وهو يخشى فأنت عنه تلهى. كلا إنها تذكرة. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, whenever he used to see Abdullah ibn Maktoum, come, the man whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blamed me on his behalf, come. That's the way you are making it conditional. That's not the deen of Allah. Either the president or I'm kafir. Go. We don't need even those. Allah doesn't need them. Allah doesn't need them. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need the sincerity, even if it's from less. Yusuf alayhi salam, he will be the servant of Allah anyway. It has ended up with the jail. Why Allah has taken me to the jail? It never happened. I was in the palace of the minister, and I have a goal, and I have a plan of da'wah, and I have an image I have to present, and I did, and I made it, and I said the truth. Regardless, I have been accused falsely, it might be another test. I have been taken to the jail, the agenda has not stopped. I need to be the servant of Allah, and I need to make it as sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we'll see what Allah described. Simple. Regardless who you are and where you are, in a small job, just once I'm going to serve it. In your place, as a carpenter, as a sanitary guy, as a cleaning man, as an engineer, as a doctor, whoever you are, اتق الله حيثما كنت. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you are. Serve the deen wherever you are. Make it to the sake of Allah based on your ability. Wallahi al-azim. It can be a dirham, a buck, getting out of the pocket of a very poor man who we might not even pay an attention to him. And the Prophet did say, سبق درهم ألف درهم. One dirham from a such man has made it faster to Jannah than 1,000 dirhams from another person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about his intention. A man, he has only one dirham and he did give it to the sake of Allah. How much he has given to the sake of Allah? Huh? 100%. Somebody has given $1 million to the sake of Allah. And his asset is $1 billion. How much he has given to the sake of Allah?
1%.
Not even 1%. 0.001. That's 0.1%. And that guy has given a dirham. And the other has given $1 million. But the heart that has sacrificed all what he has in his hand, all what he has in his life, can never be accountable before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the same as somebody who has given a pity out of his too much, even if the number is more. That is the reason Muhammad did say, سَبَقَ دِرْهَمْ أَلْفَ دِرْهَمْ. One dirham can make it faster to Jannah than 1,000. We need to have that list we discussed yesterday. Community will not be improved, will not move forward without commitment, dedication, effort to be exerted, without having my life, the life of my brothers and sisters, the life of the Muslim community, the Muslim ummah, as priorities on my list. Yusuf did make it to the jail. It's a jail. It's bad. No. Whatever I'm going to be able to make it there. Whatever Allah will allow me to serve his deen, I'll make it. And Allah did make his blessing to Yusuf after the jail because of the jail. وَدَخَلَ مَعَهُ السِّجْنَ فَتَيَانِ قَالَ أَحَدُهُمَا إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَعْصِرُ خَمْرًا وَقَالَ الْآخَرُ إِنِّي أَرَانِي أَحْمِلُ فَوْقَ رَأْسِي خُبْزًا تَأْكُلُ الطَّيْرُ مِنْهُ نَبِّئْنَا بِتَأْوِيلِهِ إِنَّا نَرَاكَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And we need to stop on that. Allah has made Yusuf in the jail, and two guys have made it with him in the same cell. One of them has seen a vision that he's squeezing khamr, squeezing grape, and the other one he has seen a whole basket of bread that the birds are eating from. You know what the verse did say? How they know, why did it go only to Yusuf, not to others? إِنَّ نَرَاكَ مِنَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. For few days, without even talking about da'wah, without talking to non-Muslims, before talking, can we get out of that session with that concept? Act Islam before speaking Islam. And that's what Yusuf did. How the two guys in that whole cell will realize that we'll leave everyone and go to Yusuf alayhi salam. Just a man, just we can see you, mashallah, praying day and night. We can see you, how you are polite, how you are honest, how you have never wrong did in any one of those who are in the same cell. He has made it in advance. We have been talking Islam, but we are acting nothing. That is the reason many of those who are non-Muslim, they used to say, we have gone to the countries of Islam and we have seen Muslims and we have not seen Islam. And we have gone to the countries of non-Muslims and we have seen Islam without seeing Muslims. Is that correct? They have seen honesty somewhere, but they have not seen it from Muslims. And I used to say the same with pain. How many Muslims you can trust to give them a loan tomorrow morning and you are sure that you will get your money back? Allahu Akbar. You know what I can see in the faces? The answer is shameful. The answer is shameful. And some of the eyes can tell me, no. No. No single one. I can deal with George. I can deal with Michael. But Muhammad, you don't know how much hard time he has given me. Money, it doesn't work. Can we believe that? In a masjid, facing the same qibla, saying, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. And I'm telling you how many of that gathering you can trust to put his hand in your pocket and you are okay with, and you're telling me, with all of my respect, if it's going to come to the pocket, I'm out of that masjid. As Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam did say, you are going to pass by a whole city and you will not find one honest person. The time will come. يأتي زمان على أمتي يمر أحدكم بقوم كذا وكذا ولا يجد أمينا واحدا. No single honest person you can trust. The Muslim Ummah, that you can give him your back, and you know that you are dealing with somebody who one day you will make it with him to Jannah. Because we have been talking, not acting. And the enemies of Islam, they have realized where they can stab us. Talk. Been saying Islam rules, principles, where are they? Yusuf alayhi salam did make it before talking. He did take his place. He showed them Islam. So they have been forced to come to his place. And telling him, and I think we have been experiencing the same in our jobs. You have been dealing with many. And one guy, you have seen him, mashallah. He's doing good. He's extremely hard worker. Honest. Taking care of his timing. MashaAllah committed. The quality of work that he's presenting is different than others. Even if he's not your friend. It's gonna take you a day, two, three, a week. Once you need to chat or share a concern with somebody, what you are doing? You are going to that person. Can we have a cup of tea together? And Inna naraka min al muhsinin. I can see you from the righteous. Yusuf, that's what we have seen. Can you interpret whatever we have seen in our vision? Inna naraka min al muhsinin. Qala la ya'tikuma. You are the one who has come to me. And that's, by the way, is different than going to spread the message. If you have acted in a way that non-Muslims will come to your place, the heart is open to receive. But sometimes you are approaching and it's completely sealed. You don't know, just it's plugged ears, plugged heart, because you are the one who's trying to approach. Sometimes it's very difficult. But if they have come to your place because they have seen you acting the principles and the noble characters, they will come with open heart. And at that time, fill whatever you want to fill. If you will tell them, guys, that's La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Ask the guys who are from Indonesia, the largest Muslim population worldwide, how Islam did enter their places. The companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and those generations after the companion, they went there for business. For months and years, they did no single act of speaking da'wah, but acting da'wah in business. And the whole country has become Muslims in few years without single sword. Everyone has come to them, Inna narakum min al muhsinin. Who are you guys? Are you angels? How you are that honest? That's the reality. How you are that honest? How you are that disciplined? How you are that quality of people we are dealing with? Who you are? And what they said at that time, we are the students of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They came with the open heart. And once they told them, we are the students of Muhammad, the next day, I have given you your request. But hold on. Where you are going, man? Just come. Ya sahibay sijn, a'arbabun mutafarriquna khayr, am Allah al-wahid al-qahhar. Once you got the chance, they are coming to you. And now the hearts are open. You are going to talk to them about soccer? You are going to talk to them about yesterday's football game? Now they came with the open heart. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, done. Why you are going to lose the chance? He gave them what they are looking for and he told them, that's what you need to understand. What do you think? Many gods who cannot harm, who cannot benefit, better am Allah al-wahid al-qahhar, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one, the most dominion, the one who has the sustenance in his hand, the overpower, the supreme on everything, Who can be better?
يا صاحبي السجن أرباب متفرقون خير أم الله أم الله الواحد القهار يا صاحبي السجن أما أحدكما فيسقي ربه خمرا وأما الآخر
the first one who have seen the himself squeezing the grape you will be the waiter of the king one day when we don't know
وأما الآخر he didn't say you and you he said one of you and one of you
because the other one the interpretation he will be crucified
وأما الآخر فيصلب فتأكل الطير من رأسه
he will be crucified and the birds are gonna eat from his head
قضي الأمر الذي فيه تستفتيان
the interpretation the game is over and that will never change
and he continued the same da'wah with them and he left the message with one of them before leaving the jail
وقال للذي ظن أنه ناج منهما
he told to the one that he knows that he will be the man working for the king اذكرني عند ربك
mention my case in front of your king in front of the president tell him about the situation I'm in I'm not worrying about staying in the jail but I want you to carry the message that I cannot be the one who can be accused by those filthy actions with women I cannot stay in that place and you have seen who am I and my file has such accusation that the reason whenever Yusuf alayhi salam has been requested to get out he said no don't tell me just after he did interpret the vision to the king told them وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ اُتُونِي بِهِ أَسْتَخْلِصُ لِنَفْسِي go and bring him I'm gonna use him as my assistant فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُ الرَّسُولُ the messenger has come to him saying Yusuf how glad tidings you have the king wanna use you as one of his close assistants get out he said no you missed the whole point how I'm gonna go out and I have my file has a bribery case or it's something proven and later on I'm gonna tell the guys fear Allah how does it work that's the reason acting Islam and cleaning your page is number one in the actions of da'wah if there is single lie has been proven for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his life before receiving the revelation from Allah, he would have never been able to deliver the message of Allah. Single. And that's what has been proven and documented by the kuffar. Huh? Oh, the kuffar. Oh, the people of Quraysh. What do you think if I'm going to tell you about a caravan that will come to invade your city coming behind the mountain? You have not seen it. Are you going to believe in me? He said, you? والله ما عهدنا عليك كذبا قط we have never seen you lying even with the unseen we are going to believe are you sure
yes
and he said I'm the prophet of Allah then you are liar because it's coming to something that will conflict with their interest but as reputation الصادق الأمين he's the truthful he's the honest he's the one who is holding the whole noble characters amongst the tribes that he was living in even before receiving the message and that was a major part of Allah's protection to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam Yusuf did make it inside the jail wherever you are the masjid the da'wah the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is on your list it should be the top nothing is going to change you are going to be in your office in IBM and you have Allah on the top of your list in the school and you have Allah on the top of your list a taxi driver a carpenter a laborer wallahi nothing is gonna change but it will increase because of the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he made it with Yusuf alayhi salam may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did open the hearts to learn from the lessons in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The credibility of the prophets of Allah is coming from the credibility of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Accusing the credibility of prophets is touching the credibility of the messenger, is touching the credibility of the one who has sent the revelation. We need to understand again and again and again, because that's affecting the faith. If there is something you are feeling, it doesn't work. There is nothing called conflict between Quran and Sunnah. There is nothing called prophets are, Musa did kill the guy, and how he is the prophet and he is considered a killer. You are misunderstanding, and you need to come and ask so you will clear the image of your faith. Because once you have that in mind, how Allah will make Musa one of the prophets and he killed the man? Because you are misunderstanding and you know nothing. If there is something does not look okay for you, to make it easy at the beginning, accuse your understanding. Say whatever is in the Quran is correct. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did reveal is the authentic. I have something that I need to make sure that I will understand it properly. So you will not get into a subject. Most of those who have become wal-iyadu billah, they lost a major part of their deen. They have started to follow the trend of their thoughts without having a barrier. As Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam did say, Shaitan will come and ask you, who has created the mountains? And you will say Allah. Who has created heavens? You will say Allah. Who have created earth? You will say Allah. Who have created oceans and seas? You will say Allah. And once he will bring you the question, who created Allah? And you are going to get stuck. Let me think. Who has... Think? Think of what? The question is not applicable. Because he is the creator. He is the first. He is the last. And close it. It's a shortcut. Shaitan is going to make it in a way that a single crack in that, in those serious subjects is making the whole building collapse, because it's dealing with the faith. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen our faith. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us steadfast in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our hearts linked to the book of Allah and the sunnah of Muhammad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our hearts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our intention. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among those who are going to learn the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, fill our hearts with your love and the love of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, bless each one of that great gathering, brothers and sisters, to be amongst those who are going to be able, inshallah, to make it soft with peace on their deathbed. And their last statement in this dunya is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi sallam wa jazakumullahu khayran. Let's inshallah go through the question, then after that we'll pray Asha inshallah. There is a dummy question to encourage a brother to ask. Okay. طب مش تفهمني طيب ان انت في اثناء مناقشة مع احد الاخوة قال لي انت عندك مشكلة في العقيدة لما قال بلى وفضلنا هذه الكلمة جزاك الله كل خير brothers جزاكم الله كل خير و that's what we discussed yesterday the brother is saying that he in one of the discussions with another brother the brother has given him a statement that's close, that you are almost out of the deen, or you have an issue with the aqidah and you should like be careful. And he's saying, I think that the statement that or the word that he told me is he's not paying an attention to, and it's really serious, and it is. Muhammad sallallahu, as we discussed yesterday, that some words, a word that you might say and you might not pay an attention to, that can get you into Jannah for 7 years. And a word that you might not pay an attention to, it can throw you in the hellfire for 7 years. And one of those words, to accuse somebody that you are kafir. And you don't have a real, you don't have even, I don't want to even say having an evidence, you have no right to say that. You have right to advise. You have right to be careful. Brother, inshallah, be careful. I heard a hadith from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam saying, but to appoint the finger saying, you are distributing judges, you have given him the card. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam did say, من قال لأخيه يا كافر فقد باءت بأحدهما. Whomever is going to say to his brother, you are kafir, one of them has been hit by that judge. One of them. If he is not, you are. It's a statement. But if you have seen something wrong that you want to advise the brother, remind him, make sure it's in a way that will be soft without showing him, even if it's serious. There is nothing could be more serious than shirk during the time of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. But the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has wisdom to deal with. We need to agree on one thing. When the asnam, when the idols have been removed from Kaaba? When? After the opening of Mecca. That means for how long it has been in around the Kaaba? 21 years. From the beginning of the revelation. But the Prophet did not give the instruction to take it away. Till he has been given the power and he has become the decision maker in Mecca. Even changing the munkar, whatever is wrong, has a fiqh, has a way in Islam. And the Prophet, so you can understand, if you are going to change the wrong with something that's considered worse, then don't change it. That's a rule in fiqh. إذا كان تغيير المنكر سيؤدي إلى منكر أشد فعدم تغييره أولى. If you are gonna change the wrong with something that will make it worse, don't change it. Don't change it.